gospel's ministry area, Eucharist, for today, the eighth Sunday after Trinity. We began with our introit, which was Christ Be Beside Me by Malcolm Archer. It was sung by Phil, but particularly, of course, featuring his daughter, Chloe. We meet together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace and peace be with you and keep you in the love of Christ. Heavenly Father, all hearts are open to you. No secrets are hidden from you. Purify us with the fire of your Holy Spirit, that we may love and worship you faithfully through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We pause and call to mind our sins. Heavenly Father, we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and have failed to do what we ought to have done. We are sorry and truly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past and lead us in his way to walk as children of light. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you and set you free from sin, strengthen you in goodness and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Forgiven our sins and given the help of God's grace to change and to grow in his ways, we sing together of the glory of God. Almighty and everlasting God, we beseech you to direct, sanctify and govern us in the ways of your laws and the works of your commandments, that through your most mighty protection, both here and ever, we may be preserved in body and soul, through our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. This is from the letter that St. Paul wrote to the Christians in Rome. I am speaking the truth in Christ. I'm not lying. My conscience confirms it by the Holy Spirit. I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, comes the Messiah, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We now join in the first of our hymns this morning, the hymn, Thine Be the Glory. Jesus heard this, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place. The hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus replied to them, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples. And the disciples gave them to the crowds. And all ate and were filled. And they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, beside women and children. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We move from parables into a miracle. Now, to me, the miracle is a very interesting one, and it's actually one that says something very important about Jesus' ministry. Now, as someone who believes that Jesus was the incarnate Son of God, for him to do anything is in its own way not extraordinary. He assuredly could do whatever he wished. But here, I always believe in this passage, there is a story about Jesus doing the most extraordinary and remarkable thing. Something far more remarkable, actually, than just producing bread or turning stones into bread. What Jesus does is actually inspire people to live according to the kingdom's values, albeit for that very little moment of time. The people have come together. They're in a deserted place. The disciples are thinking on their feet. They're trying to care for the crowd, saying, "Oh, they won't have food. They need to be sent away to get food." But Jesus says to them, as they come to him with their cares and concerns for others, Jesus says, "You do something about it. You use your own resources and do something. Offer it to me and I will use it. I will transform it." And I think that's very true of the call that Jesus makes to us today. We have great resources, great abilities, gifts of all kinds, and we are called to bring them to Jesus and to ask him to use them as he would. Now, I suppose in all probability, if you're going to a deserted place, you almost certainly would have packed some food. Perhaps everyone there had enough for themselves. But the point is, to me, when the food that the disciples had was brought forward and shared to people, everyone else put in what they had. And therefore, it was enough for everyone to have what they needed to eat. But even then, there were 12 baskets full, which were left over. There was enough and to spare. The ministry of Jesus and his teaching has always been, "Come to me, allow me to transform you. I will use you to do the most extraordinary things." And that is the most extraordinary thing, that all the men and women there are truly sharing what they have. Put that in global terms. Would the world not be absolutely and utterly transformed? Would it not be the kingdom of God, where his rule comes, if men and women all looked at what they had and offered it and shared it, so that everyone had what they needed, not a few had more than enough and to spare and hoarded it to themselves? Sometimes people say to me, "Oh, Vicar, do say a prayer for me," or "God doesn't answer that prayer." I think very often when we come to God in prayer, just as with Jesus there, he says, "Well, what are you going to do about it? It's all very well for us to pray for those who are starving, for those who have no fresh water, and rightly we should bring before God the problems and the difficulties of the world. And yes, for all of us, we may feel helpless to change the problems of the world, maybe thousands of miles away. But I'm sure God very often, as we are saying our prayers, is saying, all right, you're praying for those who are hungry. What are you doing about the hungry on your doorstep? What are you doing to make a difference? Have we had a look at what we have, and are we genuinely trying to answer our own prayers, to be the vehicles whereby God can say, yes, you did pray for these people, but through you using what I have given you, all of your resources, not just money, but in imagination, care, kindness, thoughtfulness, caring, by using these things, you are bringing the kingdom around you. You are being used by me. And if men and women everywhere are used by God, then that is how the kingdom comes on earth, that God's will may be done on earth as it is in heaven. That's the great miracle. That's the miracle that God wants to work in each one of us, that we learn to see what we have and to use it not selfishly, but for the good of all. We affirm our faith together. I believe and trust in God the Father, who created all that is. I believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ, who redeemed mankind. I believe and trust in his Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God. I believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. We're going to pray together now. Heavenly Father, as we think of the miracle of the feeding of the 5,000, we pray that we may be aware of all the gifts that you give to us and the way in which you wish us to use them. May we be aware that the gifts are for the use of all, and may we learn to be truly generous in the way we give to others. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for the church throughout the world, for John, our Archbishop, for the Mumbles ministry area. We pray that we may be seen as generous churches, generous of our time, generous of our welcome, generous in our care. Father, we pray for all the different projects that we run to seek to support and care for others. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for the world, for a world where so often the values are to keep and use the resources and abundance for the wealth of a few. We pray for all those who suffer, whether it is through hunger or thirst, those who are the victims of warfare or violence, of disasters, natural or man-made. We pray for those who seek to bring them aid and comfort. And as we pray for them, Father, we pray that you will inspire us to do what we can to show our love and care for them by the way in which we love and care for those around us. May we be very conscious that through us you wish to bring your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we bring before you those whom we know to be in times of difficulty, We pray for all who are lonely, all who are sad. We pray for those who are ill. We pray for those who care for them and those who care about them. Father, may they know your healing presence, and may you use us as vehicles of your healing, through words, through gestures, through a smile, through thoughtfulness, to bring wholeness and help to those whom we meet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray finally for those who have departed this life. We thank you for them. And we pray that we may know deep in our hearts the joy of your Son's resurrection, that even as it calls us to new life here upon earth, it calls us to life eternal, where we may enjoy forever the joys of your kingdom with those whom we have loved but lost a while from earth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we ask you to accept our prayers, spoken and unspoken. In Jesus' name, amen. Jesus said, "This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. The peace of the Lord be always with you." We have our offertory hymn, the hymn Alleluia, Sing to Jesus. We celebrate together the gifts and the grace of God. We take this bread, we take this wine, to follow his example and obey his command. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is indeed right, it is our duty and our joy at all times and in all places to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty Everlasting God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. He is your eternal Word. Through him you created the universe and formed us in your own image. You sent him to be our Saviour, born of Mary through the power of the Spirit. Upon the cross he opened wide his arms of mercy, embracing us in perfect love, destroying the power of evil, suffering and death. On the first day of the week you raised him from the dead and opened to us the gate of everlasting life. Through him you have given us your holy and life-giving Spirit and made us your own sons and daughters. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we praise your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hear us, Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Through him accept our sacrifice of praise and grant that by the power of your Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be for us his body and his blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup. When he had given you thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink from this, all of you. For this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. We proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come in glory. Therefore, Father, remembering the saving death and resurrection of your Son, we offer to you in thanksgiving this bread and this cup, your gifts to us. And we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send your Holy Spirit upon all of us who share this bread and this cup. Strengthen our faith, make us one, and welcome us and all your people into the glorious kingdom of your Son. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. We pray that God's kingdom may come and his will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, for we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Come, let us receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, given for us, and feed on him in our hearts by faith, with thanksgiving. Our communion anthem is Lead Me, Lord. Serve the Lord in the name of Christ. Amen.